Hallelujah. Are you doing great? I don't know where to start with my testimony, but I ask God that my testimony is to glorify His name, to glorify our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. And I ask God, the Holy Spirit, to impact you. Whatever that the testimony that I will share to you, that it will bring to your life with hope. There's hope. Yes. It's not too late yet. Yes. There is hope. Yes. In Jesus' name. Can you say, Jesus? Can you loud it? Because He loves us to shout, to glorify His name. By shouting, because shout, there's a power on shout. Say it, Jesus!
Jesus!
Amen. Amen. Another one, three is completeness.
Jesus!
Jesus! Jesus. Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Amen. I only prepared the scriptures, but okay. God will show me the way. He will guide me. The Holy Spirit will guide me. I want to read the scripture, 2 Corinthians 3, verses 4 to 5. We are all confident of all this because of our great trust in God through Christ. It is not that we think we are qualified to do anything on our own. Our qualification comes from God. He has enabled us to be ministers of His new covenant. So what we're doing right now, there is hope, there is faith and endurance. And Jesus is hope. It is not because of our own understanding, but it is because of the Holy Spirit who is our helper. So it is, you have faith no matter what. God gave us a measurement of faith, and whatever you're thinking right now, if you are the enemy telling you that you're not good, you're not beautiful, you don't have anything, well, you are so blessed. You are so blessed. And look at you. You're so healthy. You are so blessed. Amen. And it's not too late. It's not too late. Amen. I'm from the Philippines. My name is Susan. And in year 2003, before I got married, before my husband went there in the Philippines, he went there to get married. So I got married there, and after the wedding, I got sick, and I did not know that I was already sick, and it was a chronic disease. So I had a problem. I had a kidney disease that I did not even know of. So I got sick, and before that happened, a few years or 1 year ago, that time, I had a dream that something that I couldn't accept it. I felt like I said in my dream that I cannot believe it. This is not for real. This is not real. I know that I'm just dreaming. This is not going to happen to me. And then when I got sick, that's the time it brought back to my memory that I had that dream, and I said, "This is not real, but this is Amen. This is happening." And but because of I was a praying person, God spared my life, and from there I almost died, but because of my prayer, my faith, God saved me by answering my prayers to have a husband. I prayed many years to that God gonna give me, specifically that God gave me the loving husband who gonna love me for what I am, who I am, and no matter what his age is. And God gave me that. He answered my prayer. And through that marriage, God gave me a kidney transplant. And before I came over here in the Philippines, God told me, you have to pray while you're processing your US visa. You have to pray. And I said, I don't think you are God. Why do I have to pray if you are God? But I know that I have to pray. So I said, okay, maybe you're God. I know that I was thinking because the enemy did not want me to pray. So I prayed every night. And it was the breakthrough that I got that US visa, because you cannot come over here if you don't have insurance. So when I came over here with that disease, I brought that disease in my body, and I had a problem physically, and I was thinking that I can discern, because God gave me a I did not know that that was the discerning of the Spirit. And I discerned that I feel like I'm going to die. I'm going to die because of this disease. And I said, and then the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit telling me, you're not going to die. So I said, okay, I'm not going to die. There's life in me through Jesus Christ. There's life. And I thought that if I die that time, I will be saved. I would be saved. But it was wrong. God brought me to a revelation for repentance and to pray, to worship Him, until God gave me a revelation. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In Psalm 37, verse 4. Delight yourself in the Lord, and He will give you the desires and petitions, requests of your heart. During my third year high school, my classmate asked me, you understand that your friends or classmates asking you what you're going to be when you grow up or in college, what you're going to get for a program. And I said, I did not know about prophecy or how to get that word from God, but I said, well, what I'm going to do is to go away, very, very far away, and then I'm going to come back and give the words of God for the salvation of my brothers and sisters and my parents.
Amen.
And that, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. And that promise, God promised, I did not even know that through the marriage to bring me here in the United States of America, that's where God told me that the desire in my heart, it was that He can give our desire. So whatever that you're desiring right now, don't lose hope. There's hope, and you look so beautiful to me right now. Because God doesn't want us to be sick, and you are so blessed. You are so blessed. I can see you are so beautiful, because God sees you so beautiful. Jesus sees us so beautiful. We made in His likeness. We're just the same, look alike like God. Amen.
Amen.
In Romans 8:28. And we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are the called according to His purpose. So it was not our purpose, because we don't qualify, but it's just from our own understanding. It was from God, because He knows what we're going to be. We just had to step up and have faith and have endurance, because you're going to get the breakthrough through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So don't feel oppressed. Don't feel down, because God is so good. And like what I said a while ago, that you are so blessed. Right now, from now on, you have to say, I'm so blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm so blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm so blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Isaiah 40, verse 31. But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint or not grow weak. Hallelujah. You know, you know yourselves that the time you have a discerning spirit. You have that gift. You have that gift. You know that. But maybe you haven't heard that words yet, the discerning of the Holy Spirit. God gave you that gift already. So we know what God's promises for us, abundance, abundant in life. Jesus, God, our Father in heaven sent us, sent Jesus Christ to give us an abundant life. Anything, it's abundant, it's no measurement, no limit, it's limitless. That's how the Lord wants us to have. Amen.
Amen.
And for giving us a discerning spirit, like an eagle, you know that eagle-eyed, that when the eagle fly, you know, soar, he knows what's the error there. He knows what's going on down there. So he knows what's right or wrong. And we have that gift.
That's right.
We have that to use the goodness of God that he told us. Amen. Through repentance. We have to repent and don't lose hope. Whenever that we're done wrong, don't put that in your heart. Because Jesus, he said just to repent. No matter what, we have to repent because when I was sick in the Philippines, I was so thankful to God that he used my mom to told me to ask my father to forgive me, not because of my father committed an adultery. It's an excuse for me to ask him to ask for forgiveness. To me, that's wrong. It's about us. It's about our heart. So I asked my father, can you forgive me, Dad? And I felt the love of my God before he died when I came over here. And I had peace. At least I had peace because I said to him, forgive me for what I have done to you, for the anger, for committing an adultery.
Yes.
And I don't know what's going on in each and every one of you, but God is so good.
Amen.
Just repent. We have to love our parents. We have to respect our parents.
Amen.
because that's the enemy used me to get sick as well. Because of that, God said that he will give us long life. Have you heard that? If we respect our parents. Amen.
Amen.
And God gave me that promise. Amen. Thessalonians 5, verses 15-21. Rejoice always and delight in your faith. The unceasing and persistent in prayer. In every situation, no matter what the circumstances, be thankful and continually give thanks to God, for this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. Do not quench, subdue, or unresponsive to the working and guidance of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Do not scorn or reject gifts of prophecy, prophecies, spoken, revelation, words of instruction or exhortation or warning, but test all things carefully so you can recognize what is good. Hold firmly to that which is good. So when it is good, it is from God. I believe that when it's good, it's from God. If it is bad, it's not from God. It's from the enemy. So when I was in third year high school, when I told to my classmate that I'm going to go far away and I will come back. So God's promise is not yet done. This is just the beginning for sharing you my testimony that Jesus is so faithful. We just have to repent and always pray. No matter what, because that's the weapon that we can be blessed. That's that prayer is talking to God, communicating with Him like I'm communicating right to you right now. That's how we pray to God and meditate His word, mostly when we talk to Him, when we talk with Him, when we talk like you talk to your friends. That's how we're going to do, because that's what I always do. So if I have always a problem, I always talk with Him. And if you don't know how to pray, because the Lord's Prayer is very powerful. That's what I've been praying. That's what I always pray if I don't know sometimes what to pray or how to pray. So, and that prayer, through that prayer, I had healing, supernatural miracles that it happened to me, like my vocal cord, right?
Yes.
Yeah, that was in year after my kidney transplant in year 2005, and I did not tell anybody about that because of we have to be careful who we talk with about our sickness, because we want the one that we can trust, the who believes, who has faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The who believes the promises of our Lord Jesus Christ, like what happened to me. Because my testimony is to glorify God and to give that impact to you, that you are, that God, that Jesus, the Holy Spirit is so good. Is so good and so faithful. Jesus is so faithful. And no matter what, like what I said, one of the scriptures, that whatever circumstances, whatever trial, sickness, or depression, or if you don't have what you are looking for, or if you don't have right now that you need to have it in your life, don't lose hope. Because sometimes I'm telling to my friends that, or to the people that we are so blessed that we are so healthy. We are so healthy that we can walk, we can talk, we can see, we can clap our hands, we can raise our hands to worship Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Because our hands are so beautiful. We are so beautiful from the top of our head down to our toes. And that God made us for that. God made us that to us, to worship Him and to have hope. And to believe Him. Believe Him. Amen?
Amen.
And okay, this is the faith and endurance. James 1, verses 2-4. Dear brothers and sisters, when troubles of any kind come your way, consider it an opportunity to great joy. For you know that when your faith is tested, your endurance has a chance to grow. So let it grow. For them, your endurance is fully developed. You will be perfect and complete, needing nothing. Amen? See that? Hallelujah. You have endurance. We'll be perfected with our endurance, not to stop, not to give up. Just go on and talk to God and pray. Or hallelujah. Just like that, and that's already faith. Faith is like what I've said that God gave us the measurement of faith. You have faith. You have faith. Amen.
Amen.
Even when you say, "Lord Jesus, where are you?" That's faith.
That's right.
Because you're looking for Him.
Amen.
You know. Amen. And in I'll just read the last scriptures about hope. For we too once were foolish, disobedient, deceived, enslaved to various sinful desires and pleasures, spending and wasting our life in malice and envy, hating one another. But when the goodness and kindness of God Our Savior and His love for mankind appeared in human form as the man, Jesus Christ. He saved us not because of any works of righteousness that we have done, but because of His compassion and mercy by the cleansing of the new birth, spiritual transformation, regeneration, and renewing by the Holy Spirit, whom we poured out richly upon us through Jesus Christ, our Savior, so that we would be justified, made free of the guilt of sin by His compassionate and deserved grace, and that we would be acknowledged as acceptable to Him and made heirs of eternal life, according experiencing it according to our hope. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you, each one of you. In Jesus' name, amen.